You'll be sharing my screen now. Please tell others to join fast. Can you see the screen? Can you see the screen? Okay, thank you. Only 40 have joined. Please tell others to join us. Okay, so do you remember where we stopped last class? We were discussing about the four C's of presentation. When you are doing an oral presentation, what are the four C's that you should consider while, what that you should keep in your mind while presenting? That is, the four C's include be calm, be confident, be clear, and be concise. Okay, 1 minute, 1 minute, please. So what are the four C's? Can you say the four C's of oral presentation? Anyone? What are the four C's of oral presentation? I have just displayed the sheet, and also yesterday I have told you you should write down the main points, isn't it? Today also you should be ready with your notebook and write down the important points. Okay, be calm, be confident, very good. Then be calm, be confident. The other two, be clear and be concise. Very good, very good. These are the four main points that you should keep in your mind when you are doing an oral presentation. Should be very calm, should be confident in what you are saying, then you should make your points clear, and also you should make it very concise. Don't elaborate, simply just stick to the main points and convey the main idea. Okay, is it clear? So these are the four C's of presentation, oral presentation: calm, confidence, clear, and concise. The next is about public speaking. Now, what is public speaking? Public speaking involves talking in front of a group of people, and usually with some preparation. We cannot go to a public, go to public and present something without any preparation. So there should be some preparation before giving an oral presentation for to the public. And here in public speaking, there won't be much opportunities to interact between the audience and the speaker. That is, you might be addressing a large collection of people, and you may not be able to have a proper contact, eye contact, or you may not be able to understand the entire audience while you are presenting. And so the interaction between you and the public can be very less. That is, the interaction between the audience and the speaker will be very less, and there is less opportunity for interaction between the public and as well as the speaker. Since the number of people involved may be large, you may not be able to keep a close close contact with those to whom you are delivering the speech. So the speaker speaks and the audience will just listen. Just like we have seen people in a big hall or in a big ground, they will be addressing a huge number of people, and they may not be able to understand each one of them who is present there to listen to their speech. Just like politicians speaking to a large audience, they may not know all people present there, but they are delivering the idea of the speech that they want to deliver to the audience. So the audience just listen. Even though they have any doubts, they may not be in the situation is such that they may not be able to ask the doubt to the speaker. So that is about public speaking. That is speaking to a huge collection of people and in front of a group of people. And this should be done with preparation, since the speaker is addressing a large collection of people. Now, what are the 6 steps to successful public speaking? 6 steps defined for successful public speaking involves, the first one is clarify your objectives. So first of all, before speaking, you should say what your aim is in delivering the speech. That is, clarify the objective of your speech. Then you should analyze the audience to see if they are listening to you, or if they are serious in listening to your speech, etc. If they are not listening to you, then you can modify your speech in such a way that you can attract people towards you. Then the third step is collect and organize information. So whatever information you are delivering to the public must be clear, it must be correct. So you should collect and you should organize information well before delivering a public speech. Then the presentation. The next is prepare notes before going for a presentation. So these are the 6 steps for successful public speaking. That is, clarify your objectives, then analyze your audience, then collect and organize information. Whatever information that is needed, you should organize it well and deliver it in an orderly manner so that the audience can understand. Then choose visual aids if needed so that it can attract the audience. Prepare notes based on what you are speaking, and also practice well before you deliver the speech. These are the 6 steps for successful public speaking. Okay. Is it clear to you? How many steps were there for public speaking, correct, for a successful public speaking? How many steps? 6. Okay. Okay. Very good. Now, so just remember these points. You can write down lecture notes as I'm saying, okay? Don't simply sit and listen, just write down what I'm saying. And in the end, I will check your notes. Now let us go on to the next section, types of public speaking. So what are the different types of public speaking? And public speaking types, there are 4 main types of public speaking. 4 main types of public speaking. First one is the entertaining speech. Entertaining speech, it is a kind of speech which is full of stories, full of words or pictures and other strategies just to evoke the sensory recall, to bring you right into the moment as if you were actually there. That is, it is just listening for an entertainment, and such speeches are called entertaining speeches. And these entertaining speeches may be delivered just to engage the time of people and to convey information. It is not to convey information, but to make the people relaxed. So this kind of speech, it will be full of stories and words or pictures, whatever strategy that can invoke our sensory receptors, that will be included in entertaining speech. Okay, it can be through audio or video, etc. And these speeches, they are nothing but to make people interested and engaged throughout. So that is entertaining speech. Then next is the informative speech. Second kind of public speech is the informative speech, and they are mostly technical in nature. It is just to convey some information, like we are attending webinars and talks delivered by people who are experts in different areas. So just like that, we are listening. People delivering facts like statistics, algorithms, etc., then such kind of speeches are called informative speeches. They are mostly technical in nature, like delivering facts, statistics, algorithms, etc. An example is working of an engine. Suppose somebody is explaining the working of an engine, then such a speech is an informative speech. Or somebody is explaining the working of a computer, then again, it is an informative speech. So this is conveying some new information to the audience. It is not for entertainment. It is for collecting new knowledge or new information. So such speeches are called informative speech. Next kind of speech is called the persuasive speech. Persuasive. Persuasion means it is bringing people to do, for making people to do some action, to take some decision and perform some action, persuading people to do something. And that speech is called persuasive speech. And there are those that would make people take some kind of actions. People, after listening to the speech, people will do take some kind of decisions and do some action. For example, buying a certain product. You might come across such situations where we have salespeople coming to our home and explaining about the product in such a way that we buy the product from them. And such speeches which make us take some action or listen and change our mind and do some action are called persuasive speeches. Like buy a certain product, then people asking for vote, then donating money, etc. Donating money, we may do it by ourselves, but without any persuasion, we should do it. And speeches by salespeople, politicians, etc. These are some kind of persuasive speeches which make us take some decision and do some action. Okay, such speeches are called persuasive speeches. Then next is inspirational speech. Inspirational speech, it calls on the audience to be the best that they can be. That is, you're trying to make somebody good, or you're trying to make somebody move in the right direction. By giving them good examples and especially giving counseling for students, etc. They are all inspirational speeches, like which are given usually after school graduations and during inaugural session. We have joined a course, and during the inaugural session, the details about the courses, the opportunities of the courses, etc. will be delivered to you, and so that you will be able to you're attracted towards it, and you study well and become good learners or good you get good opportunities in your life. So to bring you close to the subject matter, inspirational speeches are useful. It will not only make you good, but also it will improve your career growth also. So such speeches are called inspirational speeches that makes somebody good, or it calls on the audience to be the best. We want the audience to be the best among them, among the categories. So we give inspirational speeches to make others good. So these are the four categories of speeches. That is, one is the entertainment speech. We just listen to the speech just for a time pass, listening to stories, words, pictures, etc. And such speeches delivered by the speaker, they are called entertaining speeches. Then other another kind is informative speech, which is delivered to give new information to the audience. Another is persuasive speech, which helps us, which after hearing the speech, we will make us take some action, take some decisions, and do some actions. And fourth one is the inspirational speech. It is just to make the audience the best and trying to make the audience the best so that they can achieve great goals and good goals in life. So these are the four kinds of public speeches. Okay. So what are the four kinds of four types of public speeches? What are the four kinds of public speeches? Nobody had written it down? You have to just give the heading and write down the four kinds. No need to write the explanation. Just write the main headings in your note. Okay. Entertaining speech. Okay. Then informative. Very good. Then third one. Entertaining speech, informative, yes, persuasive speech, and inspirational speech. Very good. These are the four categories. Very good. So write down those headings in your notebook. Okay, four kinds of public speeches or public speaking, four kinds of public speaking, and list, write down the four points. So, and those who are listening well, they can expand it also. Those who would like to expand it can expand it also. Note, I have discussed about note taking in last class, isn't it? To keep you engaged throughout the class, it will help you to remember what you had studied in the previous class. So make it a habit of writing down notes in every class. So these are the four kinds of public speaking. Next is business presentation. So we are focusing on another kind of presentation, that is business presentations. So it is a formal tutorial or an introduction of a business practice. Business presentation is nothing but it is introducing business practices or products. So to introduce something new, some new rules in business, or to introduce a new product, some presentations will be carried out by people concerned with that product or the business related to a particular organization. So such speeches, they are called business, such presentations are called business presentation. They use either audio or visual presentation materials, etc., to convey information. So the business presentations, they should be accurate. They should convey information clearly. So they might use audio or visual presentations or even statistical documents showing the growth rate or increase in the product rate or a decrease in the consumption rate, etc., may be depicted through statistical documents, through graphs or through numerical values of charts, etc., can be done for business, can be used for business presentations. And these presentations, they are usually created with software or flip charts or using whiteboards. Anyway, there are softwares available for creating presentations. We have PowerPoint presentations and also Google Slides, etc., can be used for preparing presentation materials. And nowadays, mostly in every area for presentations, software tools are being used. So that is about business presentation. That is presenting about some business practices or products is called business presentations. Presenting to the audience, it can be either to the common man or it can be to people within an organization, that is intra-organizational, that is within the organization, or between organizations, or to the public. So there are different kinds of categories of audience to which the business presentations can be done. Either it can be within the organization, we call it as intra-organizational presentations, or it can be between organization, inter-organizational presentation, or it can be to the common public. So now, what are the different kinds of business presentations? Before, we said there are different kinds of public speaking. Likewise, here also there are different kinds of business presentations. What are the different kinds of business presentations? Okay, mainly two categories of presentations. One is sales presentations, aiming these presentations aim to sell a product, and then intra-organization presentation, that is to introduce some new ideas, to deliver some information to the co-workers. Then the businessmen, they go for intra-organizational presentations. So these are the two main kinds of business presentations. One is sales presentations, and the next is intra-organization presentations. So can anyone say what are the different kinds of business presentations? What are the different kinds of business presentations? Otherwise, I'll call out your names. Okay. Nirmal? Nirmal is present? Are you present here, Nirmal? Hello? If you're not responding, I will mark you as absent. Okay, so now take your attendance. Take your attendance now. Number one?
Present.
Okay. Two? Number two? Absent. Three?
Present.
Next, you call out your numbers.
Five.
Six.
Seven. Eight.
Nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15, 14, okay, 15, 16, 17, 18, number 16, that is number 16, Ashwin, 16, 17, absent. Okay, 18.
Present, ma'am.
19.
Okay, next, continue. 20. Number.
20.
Okay, okay. Next number. 21. 22. 23. 24. 25. 26, 27, 28, 29, 28, okay, 29 present, 30, okay, 31, 32, okay, 33, okay, 34, okay, 35, okay, 36. Okay.
37.
Okay.
48, 59, 60, 61, 61, 61, 61
absent, 62 present, 63, 63, okay, 61 present, okay, Visrud, Then number 40 absent. The 28 absent. 16 absent. Number 16, 28 and 40 absent. Okay, so three absentees are there. So we'll go back to our slides. So there are two kinds of business presentations. I called out one person, right? Nirmal. He's absent. Okay. No, Nirmal is present, right? Where is Nirmal? Number 44. If you are not responding, then I will mark absent. Okay, number 44 absent. Nivedita, are you here? Nivedita. Hello. Nainika.
Yes, ma'am.
So what are the two kinds of business presentations?
Sales presentation. Okay. And intra-organization.
Very good, very good. Sales presentations and intra-organizational presentations. Very good. See, I want you to respond like this. She responded so soon. I just called her and she responded with the answer. And I hope all of you will do this again. Okay. So, sales presentations. Sales presentation, let us see what it is. As you know, these presentations are conducted by suppliers. They want to sell some products, and so those who sell products, we call them as suppliers, and they do it in front of their clients, their potential clients. Potential clients means those clients whom they expect that will buy their product. They cannot do their presentation in front of any people. Only if they find that certain people are biased to buy their products, then they will do the presentation. So these are conducted by suppliers in front of their potential clients or customers by identifying their needs. If suppose we are in need of something, and if the salespeople or suppliers, they identify our needs, and then they will come to us and they will give us a presentation so that we are convinced and we will buy the product. So they will identify our needs or deficit in an organization, and then they will suggest their products to overcome those needs or those deficits. So they first of all, they study the marketplace, or they study the individual's needs or the organizational needs, and then they go to the organization and present their products. So such presentations are called sales presentations. So they are conducted by suppliers in front of potential clients, not all clients, those clients whom they think will buy their products. So they do it in front of their potential clients or customers by identifying the needs or deficits of the customer or an organization. Suppose some organization is in need of some products, then they will go to those organizations and then they give their presentations. And these presentations are called sales presentations. Then, the second type of presentation is called intra-organization presentations. That is, intra means within the organization. So, those presentations conducted within the organization, either by one or more members of the organization. It can be by one member or one or more members of an organization to their co-workers, to people who work along with them. And it is often done for introducing new policies or new operations. So introducing some new policies to their co-workers so that these workers will follow the new policy or new operations. so that are making aware of something new to their co-workers. Such presentations related to business done within organizations are called intra-organization presentations. Okay, so these are the two kinds of business presentations, sales presentations and intra-organization presentation. Sales presentations done by suppliers to their potential customers or clients, and intra-organization presentation, they are done by members of an organization to their co-workers in order to introduce some new policies or operations. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear to you? Is it clear to you? Hello? Okay. Okay. Thank you. So now let us go on to what preparation is. Why you are preparing for your presentation? How can you prepare for your presentation? What are the points that you should keep in mind when doing your business presentation? So it is the most important, preparation is the most important part of making successful presentation, not only business presentation, for any presentation. Preparation is the most important part for a successful presentation. Without preparation, your presentation may not reach the level which you expect. So always be prepared for a presentation. Now, factors to be considered while preparing for a presentation. What are the factors to be considered while preparing for a presentation? First is the aim of the presentation. You have to focus on why you're doing this presentation, and that is the aim of the presentation. Then you should consider the importance of the subject matter, how important the subject matter is, and you should be able to convey your subject, the importance of your subject matter efficiently, clearly. Then understanding the audience. We cannot avoid this factor in any of the presentations, because you should first of all understand the audience, and then you should prepare according to the audience that whom you are going to face. So this is the most key point in presentation. First and foremost key point in presentation is understanding the audience. Then you should find out the venue or place of presentation. That is, it can be an open air where there can be a large number of people, or it can be a restricted number of people, etc. So identify where you're going to present. Then the time of the day. Time of the day also plays an important role, because morning sessions, usually people will be interested in listening to talks when compared to afternoon sessions. So if you're going to take classes during afternoon or oral presentation during afternoon session, should be more interactive and should include more audio visuals, etc., so that people get interested. And also the length of the talk. Length of the talk should not exceed too much. If it exceeds, then people cannot concentrate on the entire session. So these are the important factors that you should consider while preparing for a presentation. That is, consider the importance of the subject matter, understand the audience well, understand the time and place of the presentation, and also consider the length of your talk. You should not talk for 2-3 hours continuously. You should just limit the talk so that people can concentrate on whatever is said. Their concentration rate decreases as time increases. So that is about the preparation for an oral presentation. The next is organizing the material. How to organize the material that you're going to present. So what are the different things that you should keep in your points that you should keep in your mind when you are organizing the material that you are going to use for your presentation? So this includes the first point, blue sky thinking. Blue sky thinking. Now, blue sky thinking, it is nothing but getting some ideas about what you are going to present, and then writing it down, writing the important points down. The order doesn't matter, but whatever you want to convey to the audience, you just write down the main points which you wish to convey. So keep all objectives in mind and write down all the points you wish to make, irrespective of the order. Don't bother about the order, but as the points come to your mind, you write it down. maybe later you have to order these points in a correct way so that people can understand. Anyway, before doing a presentation, certain points will come to your mind regarding what all should be said, what all you should say, what all you should not say, etc. So write down all those important points, and writing down such points, this procedure is known as blue sky thinking. Okay, blue sky thinking, that is keeping your objective in mind. You are writing down the points that you wish to make irrespective of the order. Whatever point comes to your mind, you just write it down, and that is called blue sky thinking. Okay, next is, once you have written down all the main points, you have to select the important points. That is, the main points of your talk should be ordered. The talk or presentation, it should be divided into three sections. Usually the talk should be divided into three sections or streams, and that is, first is an introduction section. As we said earlier, there is an introduction, then there will be the main contents or the middle section, and finally there is the conclusion or the end. These are the three main sections of your presentation: the introduction, which is the beginning, the main content, which is the middle, and then the conclusion, which is the end. Okay, so you organize your presentation in these, according to these three sections. So what are the three main sections of your presentation? What are the three main sections in a presentation? What are the three main sections in a presentation? Introduction, good. Gada. Next one. Introduction, then next is the main content. Okay. Then conclusion. So the, in general, when we say a presentation has three parts: introduction, the main content, and conclusion. So organize, when you organize your material, organize it into these three sections. Okay, so introduction, tell the audience about the organization of your presentation. That is, I told you, you should include a content slide to show what are the important points you are going to present, and the content slide shows the organization of your presentation. And next is the main contents of the middle page, middle section of your presentation. It conveys the key elements. Whatever you're planning to say will be covered in the main contents. And then conclusion, it will summarize all the key points what you have already said. These are the three main sections of your presentation. Then next, while you're presenting, you can decide whether to illustrate it or not. That is, to use visual illustrations. If whenever possible or wherever possible, always go for visual presentation so that it is more understandable to the audience. So if it is possible to demonstrate, then include visuals in the presentation, so that it can be, you can clarify there, those people understand it well. So decide whether to include illustrations in your presentations in the form of graphs or charts or anything, any visuals which will convey information to the listeners well. Then introduction and conclusion. It should be, introduction should give a preview and must gain the attention of the listeners. If the introduction is boring, then the entire speech may become a big flop. So you just prepare the introduction in such a way that it will attract the audience, or it will gain the attention of the audience. So introduction should gain the attention of the audience. And also at the conclusion, you should summarize the main points, and after summarizing the main points, you should also address the queries of the audience at the end or in between. Queries can be addressed either at the end or in between, but initially you should tell the audience when you will accept your queries. Some speakers, they prefer asking questions in between, whereas some speakers, they encourage queries fully at the end. So they will initially, before, at the introduction itself, they will convey it. That is, whether to ask in between, interrupt them in between, or to ask questions at the end. So, and then we have the conclusion section. It summarizes the main points and end the presentation decisively. That is, that some decisions will be taken at the end, and it will end the session. Well, and there is questions may also be addressed at the end. It can be addressed at the beginning, or you can address questions at the end also after conclusion. Okay. So again, there are some points to be considered in presentation. There should be introduction and conclusion for your presentation, and then there should be self-introduction. I think this was covered yesterday. So anyway, we'll continue in the next class. Okay. And answering questions. So is it clear to you? Is it clear to you? Hello? Any doubts? Any doubts you can ask? Okay. Either in between or at the end, as I said now. I encourage questions in between as well as at the end. Okay. So thank you very much. I think your time is up. Okay. Thank you.